Now, Parliament today passed the 28.9 trillion shilling budget. On Newsnight, we're going to talk about whether this budget is actually progressive or as laid out by Amos Lugorobi, the chairperson of the Budget Committee, weak and not up to the standard that will help us get to middle income status. That's coming up on Newsnight.
Newsnight is brought to you by Kampala Electric Mart, proudly associated with Chint.
Joining me on Newsnight is the Minister of Planning, the Honourable David Bahati. Welcome to Newsnight. Honourable Amos Lugorobi seems to, well, punch so many holes in the budget. And if I can quote, he called it a wasteful spending in some areas. It lacked accountability and no value for money in its execution. What do you react? How do you react to those statements?
Well, I think he was referring to the budget that we've been implementing, the one for 2016-17. It is through the areas that we have performed very well. There are also areas where we had some issues to do with value for money and all that. But I think the budget that we were debating is the one for 17-18. Which started, the process started in September last year, began at the district level, regional level, and now we've been in Parliament for almost 4 months. So we are grateful today that we have passed a budget of 29 trillion, mainly to serve a number of priorities as we have laid down in our manifesto, but also in the National Development Plan.
A couple of things there, Honourable, where about 30% of the budget is geared towards paying of loans, which some people have said does not make financial sense, whether at the national level, even at the individual level.
Well, it makes financial sense because we have a budget of 29 trillion. How is it going to be financed? 15 trillion is going to come from our domestic revenue. Then we have non-tax revenue. We have domestic borrowing and external borrowing. So where you have a budget that you don't have enough resources, domestic revenue to finance it, of necessity you have got to go out and look for money. So the borrowing is essential to finance the our needs, but at the same time, we need to ensure that when we borrow this money, we implement it and get value out of it.
One of the reasons, especially it's going to be the riding theme for the budget, the working theme, is domestic revenue mobilization. How are you ensuring you're doing this when you have a list of close to 20 plus companies getting out of the ordinary tax holidays? How are you ensuring domestic revenue mobilization when you're not encouraging them to pay taxes to this economy?
Well, the purpose for one of the reasons why we tax is because we need revenue. We also need to grow the economy, this revenue to grow the economy. But at the same time, we need support some companies to grow the economy. And that's why we have been giving incentives, tax incentives, some of the companies like Bidco, we have given Bidco, we have given Aya, the companies we have given Kolite Chemicals for obvious reasons. And we believe that when we give them tax incentives, the money that should be paying in taxes will be again reinvested in the economy, and they grow, they create jobs, and give more money actually in indirect taxes.
What then do you say to voices that will say you are stifling the growth of businesses in this country by not even encouraging Ugandans? Majority of the businesses pay huge taxes, and just a few weeks ago traders were striking because every day there seems to be a new tax that is included, while the foreign investor who may even do the same business as the Ugandan is not taxed the same.
Well, I think this time around we have not really increased taxation. The only area which we have touched was in the real estate. We have been having people who get rentals, but the capacity to collect tax from the rentals has been a problem. And one of the reasons was the value that we use for taxation. That's why we passed in the tax bills a proposal to now allow the minister, with the approval of parliament, to estimate if, for example, you have a property at Kampala Road, the minister will be able to say, around this area, using, of course, government valuers, a square meter is this much,
yes,
rather than depending on the landlord, who sometimes can underestimate.
Yes.
It's important that we pay taxes, because when you pay taxes, you grow your economy, you contribute something to your country. Mm. But I must say that the budget, this budget, 29 trillion, has a number of priorities that we are focusing on. And one of them is to increase productivity in agriculture.
Mm. But you've the other one, the allocation to agriculture.
Yes,
how
the adjustment that the committee has done in the budget for agriculture is not actually cut. It has allocated money from seedlings and other areas and put it in water production, water for production.
Mm-hmm.
That's very important for agriculture. That's also very important. Water is also important for health. So it's you don't have to look at it in isolation. You look at it from different sectors, but also important to note, we are going to be investing over 1.5 trillion in infrastructure, especially for oil production. If we do the 10 roads in the Bunyoro region, an airport ready to start production for oil in 2020, I think that will be a good contribution to the economy.
The chairperson of the budget committee saying that you have sectors that are not, do not have strategic plans in relation to the National Development Plan too. You have sectors that have draft strategic plans. You have sectors that have nothing at all. And he recommends that these actually not get any allocation because they seem to be wasting money every financial year. And he cites trade and tourism, works and transport. He also cites the judiciary, which may take about 18 years to clear the backlog of cases in its current form, but is still underfunded.
Yes, you remember we have a national vision 2040. Out of the national vision 2040, we broke it down into the national development plan, which we plan on a 5-year basis, and then we have annual plans. Our strategy was to ensure that all sectors get now strategic plans, so that we are able to budget for what you are planned for. Unfortunately, and I agree with the chairperson of the committee, out of the 18 sectors, only 7 have strategic plans.
Yeah.
And we've been putting a lot of pressure. Actually, we had the thought of probably doing something to stop the budgeting process for these sectors, but at the same time we said it would be affecting the service delivery for the people of Uganda. But we are going to ensure that if you're an accounting officer of a sector and you don't have a strategic plan, then you're doing nothing in that sector. You should be sacked. So we are going to be emphasizing issues of strategic plans, and one of the loopholes we have identified are issues to do with capacity, having capacity to plan for sectors, and it's something the National Planning Authority is working on. We hope next financial will have improved, and probably all the sectors will have the strategic plans.
Honorable Bahati, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Well, the budget will be read out on the 8th of June 2017. Make sure you watch out for that. Of course, we'll be following. Start the conversation on that on UG Budget 17. That's the hashtag I'll be working, and we'll definitely be making sure we update you on this.